No cóż, wracamy, słuchajcie, Data Bio ma jakiś filmik do nas, dla nas, powracam z wakacji, lecimy z tym, nadrabiamy wszystkie zaległości. Zobaczymy, Broy's Coming Back to Us, G-Man Savior. Okej, okay, czyli 75. odcinek jak będzie wyglądał. I have also been watching Boom lately, and I may have bad news for you, but we will talk about that in the video itself. Basically, I am going to read your theories again that you wrote in my Discord and also under the last
Złe wieści? Czemu złe wieści? O co chodzi?
About Secret Agent, about G-Man, and about Astro Toilets, and about the series in general. You know, lately I started to notice that your theories are very cool. Some of them are even better than mine. So I will try to make these videos more often.
No dobra, zobaczymy, jakie teorie tutaj są.
So make sure you stay till the end so you don't miss anything. Hello friends, you're on the
Jezu, co to ma być? Co to za wstawki dają?
Like button under the video to speed up the release of the next video. And let's go. And here's what one of our subscribers suggested. I feel like next episode 75 will be Titan cameraman POV while running away from the Astros and runs into G-Man where they will team up. And I wish it were true, but I don't think it is, because in his condition he has no
Serio? Ja też tak podejrzewałem, że może coś takiego się wydarzyć, a ona mówi, że nie.
These guys are moving at breakneck speed and there's no way they'd let him go. But we have another theory about the cameraman. In the latest Skibidi Toilet episode 74, we seen Titan cameraman sacrifice himself to the Astro Toilets. But I think this was on purpose. Why? I believe that the reason he did so was to save the other Titans, but also because he wants to be infected by the Astros, so the Alliance can somehow uninfect him.
Zainfekowany? A przecież Astro Toalety nie mają takiej możliwości. To jest jakaś chora, dziwna teoria.
Then the Alliance will learn more about their technology and further advance in making better tech. But how will they uninfect Titan Cameraman? I think they will uninfect him by going to G-Man, as he was cured by the scientist he probably would know the cure. And maybe the cure is in the containers that were following G-Man as they are scientists' work.
To jest totalnie słaba teoria, wiecie, no bo w tych kontenerach wiemy, że są części do G-Mana, do tego projektu tajemnego, sekretnego, który już został ujawniony, więc to się nie łapie.
Maybe they will infect him. And although many people say that Astro Toilets can't infect agents because that's the trick of regular toilets, but I don't agree with that. And I think they have their own way of infecting someone. They could put their mind control Astro helmet on him and then he would obey them. Of course, I'm not sure if they are controlled by helmets, but we
No nie wiem, ta teoria średnio mi się podoba, że w taki sposób jakiś Tytan kamera by miał jakiś hełm na głowie.
Speculated in the last video that it's possible because all the dudes have red eyes and a helmet and even Top G had red eyes, although now they are a different color. I still believe in the theory of mind control through the helmet, but I doubt they will improve him because they don't have time for that now. And they just use it as bait to find out the location of the agent's headquarters or to lure them out and kill them. But we have a very
Wow,
cool
fajne
theory,
zdjęcie to było, nie? My theory about... W ogóle ciekawe, kiedy będzie podsumowanie sezonu. Powinien Boom to wypuścić niedługo, nie? Zwykle po 7 dniach wypuszczał, a teraz nie.
G-Man story is that G-Man was a commander of the Astro Toilets. After he got the Titan body the Astro Toilets made for him, he started a separate faction to try to overthrow the Astro Toilets and convince many of the Astro Toilets to go to his side. This explains why there are some toilets that can fly without jetpacks that are in G-Toilet's team. Currently like DJ Toilet and the huge toilets in episode 13. We know for sure in episode 13 the toilets are Astro Toilets since they fly at such high speeds at episode 5. And G-Man and the Astro Toilet from episode 60 can shoot lasers out of their eyes without any engineering. The war of Astro Toilets and G-Man's side continues on their home planet. This is explains the picture we seen in episode 74 where we can see G-Man's broken Titan body. And no, I don't think it's him from the future, but it's most likely propaganda from the Astro Toilets during the war with G-Man. The war ends off with G-Man's side loosing.
Czyli co, Astro Toalety to inna rasa?
Lost all his equipment and G-Man
tak szczerze, dziwne to wszystko, nie?
We know how G-Man acts when he is in situations when he's about to lose. Examples are episode 57 and episode 67. This also again explains how G-Man has Astro Toilets on his team. After G-Man and his very few teammates escaped the Astro Toilets, they were in search of a species so they can repopulate and take over the Astro Toilets in huge numbers. This explains why there aren't that many Astro Toilets, because Astro Toilets haven't seen any planet that they can grow numbers in, except...
Moim zdaniem pojawią się Astro Toalety, takie podstawowe jednostki, no bo takimi grupami oni nie są w stanie opanować całej Ziemi, nie? Bo są za duzi, jest ich za mało.
In the recent episode, where they finally get to Earth, G-Man and his team finally see Earth, a planet that they can repopulate in due to the population. And this is how episode 3 starts with G-Man's team of Astro Toilets.
Tylko że widzimy, że to jest zaraza, nie? I działa na ludzi tylko.
To try to rebuild his body. But the scientists never seen this technology before. The scientists never
gave up. Chociaż czy w ogóle ta zaraza działa tylko na ludzi? Nie widzieliśmy zwierząt zbyt dużo, nie? They try to rebuild this
mech. The first episode of them trying out some experiments are episode 16, where they try to put limbs on toilets. But this didn't really work out. G-Man and scientists continue trying to figure out how to rebuild the Titan mech. We've seen how many attempts the scientists tried to replicate the mech in small ways. Their first ever progress is obtaining the Titan cameraman's arm. They begin to research the arm.
Też taka trochę naciągana ta teoria, mało realna. For example, natomiast nowa rasa saws, na pewno się pojawi, to już widać.
They eventually finally figure out how to make a Titan mech in a small way, which are mutants. They begin making new mutants, and in the recent episodes, we even see mutants acting as a common Skibidi soldiers now. Scientist and G-Man are almost close. G-Man and scientists make plans to steal technology from the Titans so they can make a real Titan mutant. We can see this in the toilet space where we can see a broken camera spider. We can see the Titan arm they researched. Then we can see the TV book to make the core. They need one final thing to make G-Man into a Titan, and that's to obtain magnets. They do scientists' final plan so they can steal upgraded Titan cameraman's arm once again to steal his
szczerze nie podoba mi się totalnie ta teoria.
Finally succeeds and we're enough research. Finished G-Man's
z tym,
Titan
że
body
badaniach i tak dalej.
Scientists may have died, but his goal was already completed. And G-Man escapes the facility with the containers, and that's where we are in the story currently. And that's the end of this long theory. And I want to commend you for doing a very good job and being as detailed as possible. And now we definitely have something to talk about, and I'll tell you what I think about it. First of all, we don't know if the toilets in the early episodes were astro toilets. And neither you nor
no
I
właśnie,
can confirm
wiemy,
that this dude is an
astro toilet
just
no.
because he can fly. And I kind of said this in one of my videos, but I'll say it again. I don't think we should pay attention to those early episodes because there wasn't really as much depth to the story as there is now. Although Boom can twist the story so much that it turns out that the early episodes will be relevant again. He did that with episode 51 where he wrote that they were astro toilets. And I doubt that he thought out the whole story from episode 50 to 70. And he decided to change it a little bit. And he can also tweak the plot of future episodes that they would refer to the initial episodes.
Właśnie, pytanie, czy Boom ma to wszystko zaplanowane już z góry, czy on to na bieżąco zmienia, nie? I troszkę kręci tą fabułą. Tego nie wiemy.
To give viewers the impression that there was a deeper plot from the very first episode. And although Boom said that the plot is already written to the end, but still he can change anything at any minute. As he did with this poster with G-Man or with the description of episode 51. I mean, right now we don't have to go back to the early episodes until Boom changes something. And I doubt those dudes were astro toilets. And the reason this guy is flying is because Boom wanted to show us how serious the situation is, and that toilets are overrunning the planet, and they're everywhere. But I'm not saying you are wrong, it's just my opinion.
No, chociaż tutaj astrotoalety też inwazje robią z powietrza, więc tutaj jest podobnie, nie?
Why DJ Toilet can fly without jetpack. But I agree with you that G-Man was trying to get his body and power back all the time, and Scientist was helping him with that. But astrotoilets also helped G-Man and Scientist in this war. That means they had an alliance, which is described in this contract. But I already say this in my every video. So if you are more interested why G-Man cooperate with Astro Toilets, then watch my past videos. I also remember that the scientist had many attempts to get G-Man powers back, as we saw different copies of him. So I agree with you, the scientist managed to complete this mission even at the cost of his life. But still, this body is not complete because Boom said that it is an unfinished project of Skibidi Scientist, which means that he did not finish this project to the
pewnie to by były dopiero jakby Sojusz dokończył tego Tytana G-Mana, nie?
Actually, I doubt that the Titan body will help him against the Astro Toilets, because there are so many of them and he's only one, so I'm sure he'll team up with the agents. In any case, we are starting to get confused about these events ourselves, and if I tried to tell absolutely all my thoughts, the video would be 1 hour. And if I took all your theories, the video would be 10 hours. But one of the subscribers suggests that the secret agent doesn't teleport, but moves very fast like
Kozaczek to Polak jest chyba, nie?
The Astro Toilets, and that he used to cooperate with them, and they exchanged technology, and he used their technology to improve himself, and also the computer men race and other cameramen who work for him. And the Astro Toilets improved G-Man with the help of the secret agent's technology. But
no właśnie, mnie jedna rzecz o tych komputerach zastanawiała, mianowicie, że oni pojawiają się w te przesłanki, że są rasa komputerów będzie, to ona się pojawia. Nie liczę tego, gdzie był Cinema Man, bo to jest znak, który jest zaszyty w mapie. Natomiast wszystkie te przesłanki o PC Manach zaczęły się pojawiać w bazie Skibidi Toilet.
But then G-Man betrayed them for some reason. And the secret agent also betrayed them and went over to the side of the scientist with whom he also talked and studied information about ordinary toilets. But then something went wrong and a secret agent sent Plunger Man and Dark Speaker Man to kill the
Więc ciekawe, nie?